One of the most critical parts in 3D printing is getting a good first layer. Having a great first layer sets up an awesome foundation for the rest of your model and saves some problems later in your print. So now let's look at some of the symptoms of a poor first layer and how to fix it.
Assuming the nozzle and bed temps are correct for the filament that you're using, let's start with the problem of lifting or curling. The most likely reason is that your nozzle is too far from the bed or that your bed is out of level, which causes your nozzle to lift as it travels. The resulting failure will look something like this. Notice the gaps between the filament? Try leveling your bed and zeroing your nozzle again. You want it nice and close to the print surface, about the thickness of paper. It might also be the result of uneven cooling or a breeze on one side of your model. Even a person walking past the printer can be enough to cause an ABS print to start to shrink and lift on one side. Get something to shield your prints from breezes. Some cardboard sheeting or even a piece of paper will help. It could also be that the filament just isn't able to stick to the bed. An effective and easy bed adhesive is simply glue sticks. Get either Elmer's Disappearing Purple or Uhu White. You can also use masking tape, Kapton tape, ABS slurry, and also maple syrup. Yes, I'm serious. You can use maple syrup. It makes for some sweet prints. Especially with smaller nozzle diameters, having a thick first layer is essential. A sparse first layer will look very similar to the nozzle being too far from the bed, like this. To fix, check your E-steps and make sure the printer isn't under extruding. Or within your slicing software, increase the filament extrusion just for the first layer. A rough first layer is usually one of two issues. Either your nozzle is too close to the bed, which is causing the filament to be squished and spread as the first layer goes down, or it's because there's just too much filament being extruded. If you notice your extruder skipping like this, then chances are your nozzle is just too close. Start by recalibrating your nozzle height again and aim for that paper thick gap. Once that's set, check your extruder's E-steps and make sure you're not over-extruding filament. Finally, just reducing the extrusion on the first layer within your slicing software will help greatly. While it is better to have slightly too much than too little, the amount of filament shown here is just way too much and will most likely cause a failure if left. One of the more interesting first layer issues looks like this. You'll see some strange shapes appearing within the model. This is most always caused by a mesh error within the 3D model itself, and it's not uncommon in models downloaded from the internet. To fix this, you'll need to open the model with 3D modeling software and carefully look for the mesh errors. If you're not familiar with 3D software, this is going to be a hard problem to fix, unfortunately. Hey, thanks for watching. Hopefully that covered most of the first layer issues that you'll run into. If there's another video you'd like me to make, just leave a comment below. And finally, what do you give a 3D printer with bad breath? Filaments! See ya!